Hi, I'm Mutia.
I'm Keisha.
And I'm Heidi.
By the end of 2001, Mutia and Keisha were desperate to continue on as Sugababes, but with a band member down and their record label soon to drop them, the future was looking uncertain for the now duo. An unexpected turn of events, after recruiting new band member Heidi, would see the new lineup embrace a poppier sound and with it a rush of chart success. This is Sugababes, Angels with Dirty Faces. During the summer of 1998, Heidi Range sang in a choir alongside Liz McLarnon at the annual Summer Pops Festival in Liverpool. The two girls were both students at the Sheila Elliott Clark Stage School. It was at the school that their singing teacher told the pair about an audition for a new girl group. Former OMD frontman Andy McCluskey was looking for a female singing trio, and after a series of auditions, would eventually recruit 17-year-old Liz, 15-year-old Heidi and 18-year-old Kerry Katona. The band were named the Automatic Kittens and were soon in the studio recording demos and performing small gigs after school.
When I was 15 for I was 8 months because of the first album, and I decided that just wasn't right for me. I wanted to go in a different direction with music and have a bit more control over what I was doing, and you know, I knew that wasn't right for me. And in that time, like a lot of people were saying when they were doing really well, oh, you must be gutted because you know they're doing so well, and it wasn't, because I knew that wasn't where I wanted to go. I left.
Prior to Atomic Kitten, Heidi had also auditioned for an all-singing, all-dancing pop group helmed by Pete Waterman's former songwriting production partners Mike Stock and Matt Akin. Despite a strong audition, Heidi was deemed too young to join the group that would eventually become Scooch.
When you said you love me.
I got a call from producers I'd met previous to that in London who wanted to manage me as a solo artist. So I ended up leaving Atomic Kitten and coming to London at 16, and I was recording with them. Well, it was a tough decision to make, because obviously the music was brilliant and the producers brilliant and the girls, and I did love the music, but I was offered a solo deal by Stock Aitken Waterman, and I just thought that was a really good opportunity. So I went with that decision, and I was recording with them, and that didn't work out. And I was approached by another manager who'd been managing Eternal, and he wanted me to sign a deal with him. And I went to see a music lawyer, and she was a Liverpoolian, Sarah Stenny, and she was the manager of Sugababes, and she convinced me not to sign this deal and asked me to go with her. And so I was about to do solo with her, and then I got a call just randomly one day from her saying, one of the girls has left the Sugababes, can you come down tomorrow and audition with the girls? So I had to go, me and my mum had to go to HMV, buy their CD, and I had to learn the songs overnight and get on the train and come to London the next day, and just went into this same rehearsal room and had to sing Overload and Run for Cover with the girls and do an interview with them. And then I got on the train back home the same day, and they rang me and said, can you come back tomorrow for the photo shoot? We want you to be in the group. And that was it. And then I was in London then from, like, they put me up in a hotel. I was on CD UK a week later. I mean, it was just an absolute whirlwind.
First time I met Keisha was when it came to the audition for the Sugababes. And I'd only ever seen the girls on telly, so I thought they were quite high fashion. I got the shock of my life when I seen the two of them, because they're both really small in height, even though I am as well, 5'2". But, like, Keisha was a little bandana trainers, big massive pants, baggy jumpers and stuff. She just looked really different to what she did on telly, and I thought it was really strange.
Heidi was informed that it was highly likely the group would be dropped by London Records in the coming weeks, but another deal was guaranteed because other labels had already expressed interest. London would indeed drop the group. Shortly after, Island Records A&R, Darkest Bees, approached their management and offered them an album deal. Bees, who went on to sign Amy Winehouse a year later, had been impressed with Sugababes and their work on One Touch and saw great potential in the group. Heidi's transition into the band would not be smooth at first, with both Keisha and Lutia still reeling from Siobhan's departure, and Heidi feeling homesick and struggling to adjust to living in London. However, once the dust had settled, the girls soon formed a strong bond and friendship. In November 2001, Heidi got her first chance to experience the pop star lifestyle when the group travelled to Germany for the MTV Europe Music Awards. The trio had been nominated for Best UK and Ireland Act.
Because there's obviously three of us and there's always the two verses, either someone will take the first verse, second in the middle, and then we'll just write our own lyrics and come together, pull it together, and that's it, really.
Sometimes we come back and we've all written, like, the same lyrics because we decide on the concept before we go to separate parts of the room. We'll come back and be like, oh, well, can't you take that word out of yours, because I've got that in mind.
The girls soon returned to London to start work on their second album and would spend 7 months in the studio writing and recording material, where over 40 songs would be completed. Whilst in the studio, a producer told them about a great bootleg track he had heard in the capital's nightclubs. Freak Like Me was a track by American R&B singer Adina Howard, released as her debut single in 1995, which reached number 2 on the Billboard Hot 100. In 2002, English producer Richard X mashed the track along with a sample of the 1979 song Our Friends Electric by Gary Numan and Tubeway Army, titled We Don't Give a Damn About Our Friends, which he released under the alias Girls on Top. That song became a successful underground dance track. Richard X wanted to release the mashup commercially, but he could not get permission from Adina Howard to use her vocals, so he decided to enlist the Sugababes to re-record the vocals instead. The Sugababes' version of the song saw its official release on the 22nd of April 2002. It would become a huge hit for the group, debuting at number 1 and remaining in the top 10 for 4 weeks. The track also peaked at number 1 in Scotland and number 2 in Ireland. A remix of the song, billed as the We Don't Give a Damn mix, was used for the video and also appears on Richard X's 2003 album Richard X Presents His X Factor Volume 1.
Sugababes thing, I thought the Sugababes thing was great. I don't care what they say. Quite a lot of people sort of ask me about it and kind of think that I'm going to, you know, sort of criticise it a little bit and make fun of it. And I have no intention of doing that.
On the 12th of August 2002, the band's follow-up single, Round Round, was released. It was written by Sugababes as well as writing and production from Xenomania. Round Round peaked at number one on the UK singles chart, becoming the group's second number one single domestically. Round Round also was a success worldwide, reaching number two in Ireland, the Netherlands and New Zealand. The song would reach number three in Denmark and number four in Norway, Romania and Switzerland. In Australia, Round Round debuted at number 21 and rose to a peak of number 13, giving the group their first Australian top 20 hit.
The streets talking for ages about the people we're gonna be.
With two massive hit singles under their belt, the label swiftly released the band's second album, Angels with Dirty Faces, on the 26th of August 2002. Despite mixed reviews from critics, the band, along with new label Island Records, were delighted when the album outperformed their previous album, One Touch, peaking in the UK albums chart at number 2. It would remain in the UK charts for 40 weeks and go on to be certified 3x platinum.
Breathe in easy, breathe in easy. We talk about the places that we intend to be. But if we were there, would you be? And baby, would I be me?
I'd be me.
I don't wanna be somewhere and realize this feeling's gone. I'm lost in these senses, confusing my senses. Tomorrow is taking too long. And don't you know that you're a part of my heart? These emotions that I got from the start are still with me, babe. And I'm tripping up on my words to say.
Breathe this week, breathe in easy, breathe in easy.
Sugababes. They've had you spinning with their hits Round Round and Freak Like Me. And the beautiful new single, Stronger. Be cool, confident and sexy with Angels with Dirty Faces, the brilliant new album from Sugababes, out now.
For their third release, a double A-side of Stronger and the album's title track, Angels with Dirty Faces, was issued on the 11th of November 2002.
I'll be the one who stands.
Stronger was written by Keisha, Mutia and Heidi in collaboration with Johnny Rockstar, Marius De Vries and Felix Howard, with production by Johnny Rockstar. The song was conceptualized during the period in Heidi's life when she had not yet joined the group and was separated from her family and friends. Angels with Dirty Faces was written by the Sugababes in collaboration once again with Xenomania. The Sugababes record label Universal Island heavily promoted Angels with Dirty Faces through Cartoon Network's animated television series The Powerpuff Girls and its 2002 film of the same name. The double A-side would chart in the top 10, peaking at number 7 in the UK and number 8 in Scotland.
Your hands to the beat and shake it down like you never did before. Move a little closer, come with me. I'll show you the place to be. To me.
The girls would be whisked off to sunny Australia to record their next music video for the album track Shape, and would also embark on a small tour of the country alongside acts such as Liberty X, Pink, Natalie Imbruglia, and label mate Shaggy.
You made it, girls, do another one. Okay, if anyone's got our album, you'll know this next song. It's a bit of an up-tempo, and it's called Supernatural.
What you take, love is as love was before, so you know. surfaces looking to fall in love. But you gotta first find yourself to love someone else. Supernatural, international, unstoppable, that's just how it goes. It's practical, it's actual.
It's a fact that everybody wants to love.
Supernatural, international, unstoppable, that's just how it goes. It's practical, it's actual.
It's a fact that everybody wants to love. Hey, everybody wants to be loved.
You did quite well by seeing them at a club.
Yeah, I did run into Matthew and I spoke to Keisha really briefly at the club and I saw them at the Enemy Awards.
Brief.
It was me and Keisha that didn't get on. But
so
me and Matthew had a really nice chat and I think we were genuinely sort of pleased to see each other again. It had been like over a year.
No tears.
Laughter?
We were laughing, we were kind of like, we'd had good times, it wasn't all bad.
Upon their return to the UK, the girls would cross paths with Siobhan once again in a London nightclub. Siobhan had been signed by London Records and was recording her debut solo album, scheduled for release the following year. Siobhan would speak to Mutia and briefly to Keisha, as well as meeting Heidi, whom she thought seemed like a very nice girl. Despite being somewhat perturbed that Siobhan had managed to secure a contract with the label that had dropped them, the Sugababes still wished her luck with her solo career.
We saw them earlier, it's the Sugababes!
Sugababes would go on to win the award for Best Dance Act at the 2003 Brit Awards. Shape was released as the fourth and final single from the album as a radio mix on the 10th of March 2003. It was composed by Sting, Dominic Miller and Craig Dodds, who also produced the track. The mid-tempo pop and R&B ballad incorporates a sample of Sting's 1993 recording Shape of My Heart, whose vocals are featured in the chorus. The song's verses were changed, while the chorus that features Sting's vocals were re-recorded. According to Mutia, Sting felt that he could do better with the chorus, so came in to re-record it.
They gamble your life away, second after second and a day by day. You play the game or you walk away. It's a new turn on a blue day, and a cool deal of life for me. And it's so good. I know that the spirits are the stars of the soldiers. I know that the clubs are weapons of war. Diamonds need money for this art, but that's not the shape of my heart.
Sometimes in life you feel the fight is over.
The Sugababes' buzz around the single dimmed somewhat when they discovered Craig David had also sampled the same Sting song on his track Rise and Fall, which had begun to hit radio playlists just as Shape was being released. Shape would debut at number 11 on the UK singles chart. The song was more successful in Poland, where it peaked at number 1. On the Irish singles chart, it debuted and peaked at number 9. It also peaked at number 10 in the Netherlands. Even though Craig David's song entered the charts 2 months later, it would peak higher in the UK at number 2. The Angels with Dirty Faces album received a Platinum Europe Award by the IFPI in recognition of European sales in excess of 1 million copies. The girls also embarked on their first headline tour of the UK, as well as starting to write songs for what would become their third album. Angels with Dirty Faces would win the Best Album Award at the Capital FM Awards. Despite their success, media would continue to speculate that the trio were not getting along, with Mutia and Keisha often seen out partying together, minus Heidi. Keisha's attempts to stem the negative rumours were made harder when Siobhan announced her solo deal with London Records and began to open up about her unhappy time in the band. Sugababes would continue to work on new material and attempt to diffuse the speculation that they were not a unified band by writing and releasing what would become one of their most fresh and exciting albums to date. Thanks for watching.
Say S U G the A the B A B E S. Sugababes. Yeah. Come on, come on.